We often meet people in our business who truly inspire us. Their determination and passion for life is unique.
One such person, an Indian land woman who for the past several years has been battling ALS, also known as Lou Gehrig's disease. We first met Rebecca Hayden in the spring of 2013 when we surprised her with our CN2 Hometown Hero Award. She started every single kids program within the Bridge Mill community and inspires neighbors every day.
Rebecca, at the time of our interview, this was our first interview. She was 40 and she could still get around using a walker. She had plenty to say.
You're such a fighter and such an inspiration, and you're our next CN2 Hometown Hero. There you go.
For Rebecca, her goal is to inspire other families to cherish their time together.
We've launched the Team Hayden Challenge, which we've asked parents to sit down and videotape a message to their children.
A year later, in August of 2014, we caught back up with Rebecca when she took on the Ice Bucket Challenge to raise money and awareness for ALS. As you can see right then, she was already confined now to a wheelchair and could no longer speak.
We returned in December of last year as the neighborhood was decorated for the second year in a row with luminaries in her honor. We rode with Rebecca as she checked out the remarkable display.
You know, after those events were over, like most stories that we cover, we all get to go home. The cameras went away. We, though, never really know what everyday life is like for them.
So in honor of ALS Awareness Month, which is May, we decided to return and show you the Hayden family's reality. And not just for a short visit, an entire day. They allowed us to video journal them. And here is Rebecca's story.
It's just another morning in the Hayden home, but just another morning has new meaning with each day, because every day for the past 3 years, ALS has taken something from Rebecca Hayden to the point where she can no longer do anything for herself.
This is a crazy machine, and it'll help lift, and it's kind of like a cherry picker.
Shannon Nichols with the Joe Martin ALS Foundation comes in twice a week and has for the past year. These two say humor is everything when this is your reality.
Rebecca's fun. She's fun. So it makes life easy whenever, you know, she's still Rebecca, so we have fun and goof around and do all like normal stuff.
Here's the big picture. By 9 a.m., Rebecca has successfully gone to the bathroom, maybe. She hasn't said a word and can't without her computer that talks for her.
I wake up about 6 and listen to the kids get ready, which is heartbreaking because I am supposed to be there.
Life is a far cry from the mornings of the not-so-distant past. As she's pushed past family pictures, it's hard not to see the irony and the cruelty that this 43-year-old woman, who held down an accounting job, ran a household of five, and endlessly gave back to her community, now needs help to take a shower. Breakfast, while a serious endeavor for nutrition, is a joke as she chooses a red apple she can no longer taste, only getting food and liquids through a feeding tube. Yet her mind is sharp, and that twinkle in her eye is as bright as ever.
Her glasses, they're just a frame. They have a little reflective dot in the middle.
That dot selects letters on the screen and allows her to have a voice.
So I can type the sentence pretty quickly.
She's gonna say something funny.
We had one in Breaking Bad.
What's far from funny is that Rebecca is trapped in her own body.
But I can't give up because of the kids.
Three children, a husband, and a support system like no other. Friends quietly swooping in to fold laundry, make meals, shuttle the kids around. All those things help, but can never make it better.
By midday, she's eaten, brushed her teeth, and done her stretches as her husband makes his way down for a hello. Rebecca's husband, Tim, works from home and takes breaks throughout the day to check on his wife.
You know, this is our norm. People get to go home or they get to walk away at the end of the day, but it doesn't end or stop for us. The kids have been pretty darn resilient, though.
Wash your hands.
Okay. Considering what they have to deal with. You know, mother's love is different than a father's love, for sure. There's a different type of bond. When you're sick, you want your mommy to hug you and hold you, put your head on their lap. That's something that Rebecca's not able to do.
For Tim and Rebecca, ALS also means a different marriage. The vows in sickness and in health take on a deeper meaning.
From husband to caregiver.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. You go from being the husband to the caregiver.
Fran's also taking on new roles as this family has found much support in their Bridge Mill community.
It's been phenomenal, in this neighborhood especially. It's just, the people have been spectacular. And they're so supportive. Honestly, I couldn't do it without that. It would just be too much.
It's a project to get out the door, no doubt, but this family tries to keep things as normal as possible, which includes regular visits to the pool.
The same pool where Rebecca started the community's bluefin swim team. The afternoon, a chance for Rebecca to have some girl time.
By late afternoon, Rebecca and crew head home, choosing to walk the half mile. Just like in every neighborhood, it's hard not to stop and speak with friends on the way.
Once at the Hayden home, getting into the house is an uphill battle. Special ramps built in the garage to make the process possible. Tonight, the kids, 17-year-old Kayla, 12-year-old Reed, and 10-year-old Carissa, getting takeout.
The dinner conversation, what you would find in every household.
How was football?
Good. I'm going tomorrow.
The tough part for Rebecca, keeping up with all she wants to say.
Us isolates.
Yes, ALS does isolate.
While their support system has grown, they also know people pull back. This isn't easy for anyone.
People should be just like they were before she was sick. That's the best advice that I can give anybody. Nothing has changed with her mind. It's as sharp as it is today as it was when I first met her.
As the evening rolls on this night, Kayla helps her siblings get ready for bed.
As another day comes to an end, this mom continues to fight every day, putting her family first.
Rebecca still runs this house. I will say that. She is the general. Mobile general. It's like her little tank here. It's heavy too. It's a heavy chair.
Always coming back to that humor that keeps them afloat, knowing tomorrow will bring new challenges they will face together.
With hope for their children, the wish for a cure, and the dream that things were different.
The family truly is incredible. So gracious to let us into their home all day with cameras. And on this day, more heartbreak. Tim wasn't home at dinner because his stepmother was actually in the hospital and, in fact, just passed away from another illness. So they have so much on their plate.
And they say someone with ALS, 1 month is equivalent to 5 years for everyone else. Rebecca and her family hope their story will encourage other families to cherish their time together. They launched the Team Hayden Challenge at the time when she was diagnosed with ALS. They say parents really need to videotape messages for their children so the kids always have something to watch and remember them by.
There are so many things we learn by covering this story. We know as moms, our brains never stop. The worries, the to-do list, all those things. And Rebecca says all she can do is not send herself into a panic thinking about all of that, because for her, it's just an endless cycle of things that need to get done. Typically, people with ALS live 2 to 5 years from their diagnosis, and Rebecca is in year 3. I also asked her if she missed working, and she said she misses it all. She misses everything. That really stood out to me. So appreciate every small moment. It can be taken away.
Our hats off to the amazing Hayden family. Of course, we'll keep you posted on Rebecca's journey.